Amazon Virtual Private Cloud, VPC, is a foundational AWS service in both compute and network AWS categories. You can't even create a single virtual machine without it. Each VPC creates isolated virtual network environment in the AWS cloud, dedicated to your AWS account. It is similar to your physical data center, but traditional network components, such as routers and switches, do not explicitly exist in VPC. They abstract it away and redesign as cloud software. For example, you get a similar virtual DHCP server in your VPC that dynamically assigns IP addresses to your EC2 instances from subnet ranges. Route 53, Amazon service, is analog of DNS server. You can create both private hosted zones that you can resolve only within your VPC as well as public hosted zones. You can easily migrate your domains to Route 53 by updating the name servers in your DNS provider. If you need to expose your server to the internet, you can use temporary public IP that is dynamically assigned to your EC2 instance during the creation. The downside of it, if you shut down or terminate that instance, that public IP address will be released and you will no longer be able to use it again. To solve it, you can allocate elastic IP address. It is static public IPv4 address which is reachable from the internet, which will belong to you unless you release it. You can assign it manually to different VMs yourself. When you sign up for AWS account, you get a default VPC that you should only use for testing purposes. It comes with subnets and other network components. I'll guide you through the creation of VPC from scratch. Before you can deploy any EC2 instances, you need to create a subnet. You can use one of many online CIDR calculators to plan your subnets. We will start from the public subnet, which means that the EC2 instance virtual private machine will be able to reach the internet, for example, to download software. Also, it can be directly accessed from the internet by its public IP address. This subnet is suitable for web applications. To provide internet access, you need to create internet gateway and attach it to your VPC. If you use only IPv6 and only need outbound internet access, you can use egress-only internet gateway instead. The final step for the public subnet is to create a routing table with a default route to the internet gateway. Don't forget to associate the table with appropriate subnet. Many applications and services do not require direct access from the internet. For example, Kafka, Cassandra, Flink, etc. should not be deployed to the public subnets. Instead, you can create a private subnet. In that case, you only get outbound access to the internet that can be used to download software and install it on your VMs. For example, you can download Kafka and install it on your Linux server. For the private subnet, we need to create a NAT gateway and place it into the public subnet with a default route to the internet gateway. NAT gateway will hide and translate the private IP address of the VM to the public one to access internet resource. If you want to achieve high availability, you can create two NAT gateways and place them in different availability zones. AWS has concept of a region, which is a physical location of its data centers located around the world. Each region would have multiple physical separated data centers, which they call availability zones. It's very common for the companies to improve availability to deploy their services to multiple availability zones. The only thing you need to keep in mind that the network traffic between regions and availability zones is not free. AWS will charge you for data transfer. Some services require you to tag your subnets. For example, this tag, Kubernetes role internal ELB, EKS will use to place private load balancers. The next step is to improve security is to create isolated subnet. This subnet simply will not have inbound or outbound access to the internet. It is suitable for databases that require a higher level of protection. When you create EC2 instance, it will not have a single port open. If you need to enable communication between different EC2 instances, you would need to create a security group, which is analog of firewall. You can use CIDR ranges to filter traffic, or you can use other security groups as identities. Now, if you have multiple VPCs and you want to join them, you can create VPC peering. Instances in either VPC can communicate with each other as if they are within the same network. If you already have a network, for example, you own a data center. There are multiple approaches you can take to join them together. First of all, you can create VPN side-to-side connection and configure routing to pass traffic through the connection. This connection is established through the internet. If you don't want to route your traffic, even encrypted traffic, between your network and VPC via internet, you can create an AWS private link. It provides private connectivity between VPCs, AWS services, and your on-premise networks without exposing your traffic to the public internet. If you just need need to allow remote access to VPC. For example, for developers to debug their applications, you can use VPN client-to-site connection. This service is OpenVPN compatible, and you can use existing OpenVPN clients. It is fully elastic. It automatically scales up or down. That's why you need to closely monitor how people use it if you are budget sensitive. On the other hand, you can deploy your own OpenVPN server, which only will cost you of running EC2 instance. I have another video explaining how to install the OpenVPN server in AWS and generate client configurations automatically.